know, Robert, I just realized something. Republicans ain't got no swag. That's why they want to ban TikTok. Republicans ain't got no swag. That's the problem. And I mentioned that in the context of engaging young people in the democratic process.
Okay, I can neither confirm nor deny if any individual Republicans or the party in general has or has not enough swag to make it work on TikTok. But many Republicans, and not just Republicans, this often gets lost in the conversation, there are Democrats too, are pushing for TikTok, an incredibly popular social media app, to be banned here in the United States. And that has resulted in the CEO of TikTok, Shouzi Chu, testifying before Congress literally as we speak. We're gonna give you some of that video, but you should bear in mind that they are throwing accusations about access to private information, the possibility that that information might be shared with the Chinese government, all these national security concerns and all of that. You already had Kathy McMorris Rogers, the House Energy and Commerce Committee Chair, saying that it should be banned. You have Representative Rogers going on to say, we do not trust TikTok will ever embrace American values, values for freedom, human rights and innovation. First of all, I'm gonna need some citations on those being fundamental American values. Anyway, TikTok has repeatedly chosen the path for more control, more surveillance and more manipulation. We're gonna get to the CEO's testimony, but Jessica, I know that you are a prolific user of TikTok. What do you think about this ongoing campaign to get a ban?
Yeah, good luck, man. You're gonna lose the entire youth vote if you ban TikTok. And it's pretty clear to me that the reason that they wanna ban TikTok is because these folks get lobbying money from and have stock in US-based multinational corporations. And the idea of a popular media platform not being a US-based multinational corporation, although there is TikTok US, they're really upset about that because TikTok is a source of information for a lot of young people that rivals the propaganda machine that's been running for a very long time by US-based media companies that run on advertisements from America's largest corporations. It's pretty clear to push a particular narrative with that. But when you have creatives that want to just get the word out or spread some truth on TikTok, those posts tend to do pretty well. There's no advertisers that can block those. So I think that's really what's at the heart of this.
Yeah. Yeah, I think a lot of the concerns are probably overplayed. That's not to say that there shouldn't be oversight. I mean, this is a major tech company. I think that often they're given far too much of a pass by those in power. But you also cannot ignore the element of just wanting to gin up some sort of ongoing Cold War with China and how that's influencing all of this. And probably combined a little bit with the fact that our older than the average American representatives probably find TikTok to be a relatively foreign concept. And I get that, even for me, it's, you know, I have my issues too. And I have to say that I was really against the idea of banning it, but I put up a TikTok about Trump being arrested and it didn't do very well. So now I'm on the fence. I'm willing to see what arguments are made in Congress today. And you can make changes to the app. You can suggest them. I personally think it should have a feed. I think it's really weird that you see things that are like 3 months old when what you want is, you know, news and all of that. But those are small things that they can take care of as they try to appeal to more and more consumers. I don't think they necessarily require the Democrats, the Republicans teaming up all of the Power Rangers to take them down.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.